It is the next day, and as you can see, the circle of death did not catch anything. But I'll keep you updated. Hopefully one of these days it nails that red fox. It got a lot of rain last night, and I think kind of froze up on me. So hopefully it gets warm today and everything thaws up and might get into something there. We'll find out. Look at the deer taking off down through there.
There's a pile of them.
Geez, there is. Making all kinds of noise. Okay, folks, we're back here checking the circle of death this morning. I had it set off all week. Last night I came and reset this, and we got some snow. You can see I had a fox come right up to it last night and hit this trap right here. And I missed it somehow. You can see where it took off running like crazy through there though after I walked up to it. You can even see where it peed on my mound. So I'm gonna reset this trap and keep trying. Okay, so I just remade that set. I took and scraped all the snow off the other ones, hoping that if it warms up today, it'll kind of thaw them other sets out. Hopefully this fox makes it back tonight. You can see he came right up through here. That's where he took off running away from the trap when it set one off. But I stunk it back up and it's got lots of eye appeal. We'll see if it works out. Kaylee and I are up here at the farm, and I reset my fox trap down here last night, and of course it snowed a bunch, so I'm sure the set's crap. But I had it set off the whole week while I was at school. But we'll go down there and check it out. But as I stand here, there's a huge flock of turkeys and a whole bunch of pigeons sitting right out here. So we have lots of fun to come. There's all the pigeons right there. And the crap. And then right down there, a whole bunch of turkeys, some long beards in there too. So things are looking pretty good for us come this spring. We'll go check this trap out.
Beard's so heavy he can't fly.
Yep.
Two more up farther.
Well, this is where our hay set used to be, and obviously snowed a bunch the other night and now it's totally covered. I'm gonna wait to reset it until some of the snow melts. How's it going, everybody? I just got back from class today, and my buddy Colton and I came out and set some beaver traps the other day just on a couple little runs that we could find. I'm not much of a beaver trapper. I haven't done it since I was like 12, 13 years old with a good friend of mine. But Colton wanted to catch some beavers, and I wanted to get back into it a little bit too. So we set four conibears, and you can see this run right here. I actually checked this trap with a drone and seen that I had a beaver in it, but the dam's way up there, and the duck blind that we shoot all the ducks out of is right outside that. And we set this 330 right here in this run, and we nailed one. The actual beaver hut's over there about 60 yards, so we're quite a ways away from it, but I could see they're coming up and down through here. So, I'll pull this guy out and see what we got.
Oh,
That thing definitely was not a very good teeth brushing regimen. We got another trap quite a ways up here, but I'm walking across some pretty sketchy ice here. A trick I learned a long time ago is to keep your feet and your stance really wide to disperse your weight over as broad of an area as you can, and you should be good. Didn't wear my waders because they're wet, because I got a hole in them from the other day. Okay, we made it through there. Wonder what the odds are I could drive my gator out here. Seems pretty frozen. I have no idea. Yeah, you can see where I walk back and forth from over there. And
look at the size of this coyote track from last night.
That's a big, I mean, there's my hand right there. Walked right up through there and actually went and marked that stick coming off that hummock there. Pretty big coyote. Probably after my beaver.
Well, I know you guys have all been wondering a lot about that trap I set on the last trapping video that I called the Circle of Death. Unfortunately, I had to set those traps off just about two nights after I set that. And we got a bunch of snow and stuff. As you can see, it's all covered up. All the traps are set off here. You can see, though, the past couple days I've had fox right on it. You can see there's a fox track. Right there's fox. Right there's fox tracks, but they're just, all the traps are set off, so I'm going to uncover everything and reset this and wax dirt. The last, the extended forecast, I don't see any snow for the next 4 days at least, so that's a good thing. We'll go ahead and get this all reset and get back after it.
Well, as you can see, I finally got all the traps dug up. I'm going to go ahead and make this reset here. Okay, folks, I feel like this is my very last fox and coyote trapping hoorah of the year right here. This is a really expensive set for just one fox or coyote. With all that wax dirt, stuff's not cheap. But it's all reset. It is, for the most part, freeze-proof. And there's been a lot of activity on this hay mound here. I think the same fox has been raiding me over and over and over again over here, but maybe this time we'll nail them. I know a lot of you will say I didn't blend that wax dirt in very good, but I literally don't want to get any of this wet stuff on those traps at all. I mean, this stuff freezes so hard and pretty much ruins the set. So I'm gonna go ahead and
get on out of here, and hopefully it works, and you guys will find out if you guys keep watching this video. Hopefully I'll have a fox or coyote in this set tomorrow morning. We will see. Okay, everybody, we're down here on the beaver pond. You can see the beaver hut is right there, and the dam, there's like three dams that run down there toward the road. And I had this 330 set on a run down there for the last couple days and haven't caught anything. There's not much beaver activity below the dam. I think they're coming right up through here, and they're feeding up in this stuff. They have a big feed bed, I don't even know what you call it, where they store all their poplar twigs over there, but it's too close to the beaver hut. It's not legal for me to set the trap there. And there's a huge run from the beaver hut to that spot, but like I said, it's not legal for some reason. Seems like it'd be a really good spot for a trap. But I'm gonna come up here, and this was all froze solid the other day. This wasn't even open, but now you can see there's definitely a run that goes through here. So I'm gonna set this trap right in here, and I'll set the camera up for you guys and set it. All right, now that I got that opened up, you can definitely see a pretty clear run there where these critters are going through. I'm sure there's a bunch of muskrats coming through here too, but hopefully I miss them. But if I get them, I'll skin them up and have me a muskrat. So I'll get this set in. How's it going, everybody? I'm gonna conclude this trapping video with this last bunch of trap checks, which unfortunately I'm pretty much already done. I forgot my camera in my truck, and I went up to what we call our upper farm, which is a little ways away from the main farm. But I've done pretty good today. I've caught two raccoons, unfortunately, in dirt hole sets, which drives me nuts, but I'm not gonna waste them. I'll skin them out and put them in the freezer. But I got a big beaver up there. And this is the trap I set on video with you guys yesterday. And I can tell that the trap went off. And you get up here close and look, exactly what I was worried about was nailing a muskrat in there, which is exactly what happened. It's not a big deal. I'll go ahead and skin him out, get this reset, and hopefully a beaver will come through here tonight. I still have a couple traps to check. I did check, as you guys saw, I checked this trap this morning before school, and I checked my circle of death trap before school this morning as well with a drone. I just came up here and sent the drone, which didn't see anything in it. And I didn't see anything in this trap, but I could tell it was set off. But there is indeed a muskrat in here, so we'll go ahead and pull this rat out. There it is, muskrat. Dang near made it through there. But we'll go ahead and get this guy out of here and get a reset. Okay, there's the reset. I actually kind of moved, the trap was up here, but I moved it down over here. It kind of zeroed in. The trap's definitely a little off kilter in there, but that don't matter. The hole is where it needs to be, right where they're gonna get smoked. So, got some deer out up here. Above me. This muskrat, I don't think was in the trap this morning. If you can tell, it's still kind of pliable and warm. So I think that I just recently got it. But we'll get this picked up go check a few more traps. I was walking down through here to check my last few traps, and I saw something catch my eye in this run here. Looks like a turtle shell. Walk in here and grab it. I'm gonna say that's a turtle that got shot. That's a big turtle. Definitely a bullet hole, it looks like to me. Not a rocket scientist or I don't study forensics or anything, but I'm gonna say that's a bullet hole. Huh, pretty cool. Boy, somebody could really pound the muskrats in here. Look at this. There's one house, two houses, three houses, four houses, five houses. There's five muskrat houses within 20 feet of each other right there. Well, I had another beaver trap in there in a run, but it was set off. I assume a muskrat swam through there and set it off. I didn't actually catch the muskrat though. But I'm gonna go ahead and conclude this trapping video. I hope everybody enjoyed it. If there's anything you guys wanna see different, just comment down below and I'll try to fulfill your needs with whatever you wanna see. Trapping season is coming to a close, at least for the coyote and fox. I don't have too much longer left here. Hopefully the circle of death provides big red fox or a coyote. We'll find out, and if you tune back in, ooh, this is sketchy right here. I don't want to walk through that. That's deeper than it looks. So until next time, everybody, good luck at whatever you're trying to do. And if you want one of these sweet Kill 'Em Outdoors hats, all you gotta do is email my old lady, KayleeSheldon10@gmail.com, and she'll send you an invoice wherever you want. We got shirts, hats, barrel stickers, all kinds of stuff. I'll be back out on the trap line in the morning, and I'll bring that on another video here soon. Really appreciate it, everybody. Have a good one.